for a thing to have effect and to be declared as void or to be made void. It was held in this case, Verne versus IRC, that it is the duty of the judge to make what he can do of a statute, knowing that they are meant to be operative and not declare a statute unworkable. So if it is present, it is given, there has to be some intention behind it. You have to make it work and not declare it void. You don't have the authority to declare it void. Who has the authority? Lawmaker has. Lawmaker had authority to create, he will have authority to reject or make it void. This judiciary doesn't have. Okay? So until the law is altered or modified or amended, the court has no choice but to enforce the law as it is, but give some meaning to it. Correct? Aids means anything which helps you to understand. So it can be statutory or non-statutory. Statutory means what is available as statutes. Like for example, definitions given in respective act or some provisions given in IPC, CPC, CRPC. Okay, or General Clauses Act. Non-statutory means what? As per customs or case law. Correct? Or rules of interpretation. Case law, importantly, correct. Case law. So rules, we have primary rules and secondary. Under primary, we have literal, reasonable, harmonious, beneficial, exceptional, adjudicem generis. And secondary, effect of usage, associated, what? Nocicur, society will come in this. Remember that word? Nocicur, society. Nocicir, anything was here? Okay, we'll discuss. Primary. Primary means important, first one. Correct? Pehla wala kya hai? Literal construction. As it is, literally construction. So, what is the first rule? Primary, cardinal. Cardinal means what? Most important. Okay? Most important thumb rule you can say is what? For construction, that words, sentences and phrases of a statute should be read in their ordinary, natural and grammatical meaning. Elementary, the most basic rule is what? The words and phrases of technical nature are prima facie used in their technical meaning or else in their ordinary popular meaning. So if there is a technical word, the first preference will give to technical meaning. Otherwise, only in that case, ordinary popular meaning. A word which has a definite and clear meaning should be interpreted with that meaning only, irrespective of its consequences. When a choice has to be made between two interpretations, one is a narrower, other is wider. In such situation, if the narrower interpretation would fail to achieve the purpose, one should adopt the wider one. Okay? Two interpretations are possible. One is a shorter, one is a larger. You will give preference to larger only when the shorter one fails. And how will you interpret the words and phrases? According to rules of grammar. Okay? So you can remember this. Literal construction, rules of grammar. In some case law. And then what is this legal maxim? Where the language is plain and admits only one meaning and there is no room for interpretation and only that meaning is to be enforced even though it is absurd or mischievous. You will give that meaning only. Then what does this mean? Next maxim, it means the simple proposition needs no expositor. That is when you have plain, words capable of only one interpretation, no explanation to them is required. So whatever is available, simple plain explanation is available, use that. Courts cannot add words by their own discretion, even for those matters which should have been. It is certainly not the duty of the court to stretch the words used by the legislature to fill in gaps or omissions in the provisions of an act. Fine? So what is available, interpretation is clear cut, use that. If there are two possible construction of a clause, one a mere mechanical and literal based on the rules of grammar, another which emerges from the setting in which the clause appears and circumstances in which it came to be enacted and also from the words used therein, the courts may prefer the second construction which though may not be literal, but maybe a better one. That means this is a more logical, liberal construction. When there is two possible interpretation, one is very literal, grammatical, another one is more liberal, and liberal makes more sense, you can give preference to that interpretation, liberal interpretation. Then different headings of literal interpretation. So what do we have under literal? Natural grammatical meaning, explanation, exact meaning leading to a loose meaning, technical words in technical sense. Natural grammatical meaning, natural, ordinary or popular sense and must be construed according to the plain literal and grammatical meaning. Kya example liya tha hum logon ne? Beetle leaf, na? बिटर लीफ विल नॉट गिव टेक्निकल मीनिंग, दैट इज नॉट इट्स, क्या बोलते हैं उसको, बॉटनिकल मीनिंग, बट विल बी नोन एज पान, दैट इज द पॉपुलर मीनिंग दैट विल कंसिडर, करेक्ट. एक्सप्लेनेशन क्या था? When it is said that words are to be understood first in their natural ordinary popular sense, it is meant that words must be qualified that natural ordinary popular meaning which they have in relation to a matter with reference to which and the context in which they have been used in the statute. In the constitution of statutes, the context means the statute as a whole. It is also called popular meaning test. Popular meaning test. I think I told you two tests, that one is a name test, another is a use test. The name may be different, but the use may be different. Correct, no? For example, water. I had given you water in liquid form and water in physical, solid form. They, both of them are water only as such technically, but their names are different, water and ice, and the use are also different. So you have to use that interpretation as well. So livestock usually means domestic animals, livestock, but they will not include hen or chicken, chicks, okay, in popular sense. Exact meaning is preferred to loose meaning. Every word has more than one meaning, so correct, no, double meaning. So every word has a secondary meaning too. Which will you give preference to? Exact meaning. Wherever the secondary meaning points to that, the meaning which statute meant, preference should be given to secondary or loose meaning. Okay, you'll give preference to secondary loose meaning when it is giving you again the intention of the legislature. Technical words and technical sense, this is okay, this we have understood already. If there is a word which is has technical meaning, you'll first give preference to technical meaning only. Rules of reasonable construction. This legal maxim, what is the meaning of that legal maxim? That words of statute must be construed so as to lead to a sensible meaning. Sensible interpretation, little liberal, logical. So, while interpreting a law, two meanings are possible. One is absolutely vague and meaningless, and the other is leading to some meaningful interpretation. You will give preference to that meaningful interpretation. Yes? So, if the court finds that giving a plain meaning will not be fair or reasonable, in that case, it is their duty to depart from the dictionary meaning and use some other interpretation and adopt a construction which will advance the remedy and suppress the mischief. This we are discussing. Or this is the meaning, or this is how it is, reasonable construction. No, no. Aage wale hai na, aage hai na wo. Hayden's rule, purpose of construction, harmonious construction, bolo. Mutually exclusive events, harmonious. So what do you mean by harmonious? Harmony, that means in some good form, there is nothing breaking as such. So you'll try to, if at all there are two provisions in the same act, correct? First of all, it is in the same act, we are saying. Then, and if both of them are not, you cannot give effect to both of them at the same time. If you read them individually, what is the then work of the judiciary? As far as possible, try to give effect to both of them. Remember something? We have also discussed none of the acts, provisions are mutually exclusive. That means basically it is not that one provision will stop other from getting, one provision will not stop other provision basically giving effect to. Yes? So the principle is the legislature never intends to contradict itself by providing two incompatible or conflicting provisions in the same statute. Incompatible means they cannot remain good together. Okay, they don't go hand in hand that way. So that is never the intention of legislature. So the act has to be read as a whole and the provisions has to be harmonized by giving effect to all of them. Correct? So the court will try to give effect to both the provisions by harmonizing them with each other. They will try to find some middle ground. Yes? The provisions of one section cannot be used to defeat other provision in the same statute. So it is duty of the court to avoid clash between two sections. If they cannot be reconciled with each other, they should be so interpreted as to give effect to both. That means still both of them have to be used. Correct? Fine. When after having construed the provisions, the words are capable of only a single meaning, the rule of harmonious construction disappears and it is replaced by rule of literal construction. Now, this is okay. It is impossible to avoid inconsistency. If it is impossible to avoid inconsistency, the provisions which was enacted or amended later in point of time must prevail. Okay. Later in time, that means what? Any of the provisions which was enacted or amended later, that means fresh one, correct? Now, latest one will prevail over the little older one. If you cannot bring both of them together, in that case, the section which was recently introduced, fresh, latest one, or the section which was latest or fresh one, amended, that will prevail over the other one, right? Harmonious construction. This is how it is, the important one. We are still under primary rules, under primary fourth one, beneficial or hindrance or mischief rule or purposive construction. What will you write over here? Suppress the mischief, advance the remedy. Remember, hindrance case, hindrance rule also, 1584. So what do we use basically while using this beneficial construction? What was the position before the law was enacted? Correct? What was the mischief for which the previous law did not provide? Correct? Then what was the remedy that was available in the current act? Correct? Then whether it has actually happened or not, and the reason for the remedy. Thus, factors adding, advancing, continuing or hiding mischief must be suppressed by the court. Correct? Remember that. What was the law before the act? What was the mischief which the law did not provide? What is the remedy that the act has provided? And what is the reason for giving that remedy? These are all four things you have to consider while giving interpretation under this rule, correct? So this act, under this the provisions are going on, no? Provision means proceedings are going on. There is an act in place and you are interpreting that act, okay? So what was the position before that act came into place, etc., etc., you have to understand. So what is the mischief? What do you mean by mischief? This is not given in your notes. So the mischief that makes the statute defective or inadequate, incompetent, etc., etc., unable to provide remedy, or defeats the very existence or purpose of statute, very important, okay? The main intention of the act is lost, that is a mischief. He who acts through another is deemed to act in person. Where a statute requires something done by a person, it would generally be sufficient compliance with it. If the thing is done by another person on his behalf and by his authority. So we have seen already in general clauses act as well. Correct? Under his authority, it will be same. Fine. We'll move now. Rule of exceptional construction. Kya tha ye? The rule of exceptional construction stands for elimination of statutes and words in a statute which defeat the real objective of the statute or make no sense. It also stands for construction of words and, or, may, shall, and must. So you can remove some words also by using these rule of exceptional construction. Uske andar hai na sub common sense rule hai ke nahi? Despite the general rule that full effect must be given to every word, if no sensible meaning can be fixed to a word or phrase, and it defeats the real object of the enactment, it can be eliminated or removed. Correct? Again, meaning thereby that it is better for a thing to have effect than to be declared void. So you have to keep it instead of declaring the entire provision as void. Conjunctive means bringing together, and disjunctive means separation. Correct? So conjunctive mein and aaya aur aayega. And disjunctive mein or. And can it be used some opposite way also? The word or is normally disjunctive and is conjunctive. However, at times they are read as vice versa to give effect to the manifest, intention of the legislature and as disclosed from the context, that means the text part of the act. This would be so where the literal, where the literal reading of the words produces an unintelligible or absurd result. That means vague understanding or vague construction comes into place. In that case, you can reverse the meaning of these words. In such case, and may be read as or may be read as and, correct? When will you use this? When the exact meaning is coming, some absurd meaning, vague meaning. When you use or as or and as and in that case, okay? And the meaning is very absurd, in that case, you can reverse their roles. May, must, shall, this again we have already done. May, compulsory, not compulsory. Must, shall, compulsory. And again, at times they may be reversed. Yes, no. Where the word may, there is also something known as, correct. If it puts advantage to public, may will be treated as shall. If it puts duty on public servant, may will be treated as shall. Yaad hai kuch? If it gives benefit to public, the word may, that means again voluntary, will be treated as shall. And if it puts duty on public servant, that duty is compulsory. Aisa kuch tha? May will be treated as shall again. Let us read that last word. While undoubtedly the word may generally means, does not mean must or shall, yet the same word may is capable of meaning must or shall in the light of the context in which appears, in which it appears. Is okay. Where the word may involves a discretion coupled with obligation, okay, or where it confers a positive benefit to the general class of subjects, or where a remedy would be advanced and a mischief suppressed, or where giving the word a directory significance would defeat the very object of the act. Okay, correct. Remember this. Agar kuch fayda hota hai, the may can be treated as shall, etc. Agar again, if it puts some duty on that public servant, again may can be treated as shall and so on. Remember, may will be treated as shall. Correct? Duty as shall, na? No. Check now. Where the word may involves a discretion coupled with an obligation. Correct. Now, discretion means choice with an obligation, means duty. There is a mixture. Duty kiske upar? Public servant ke upar, na? Let us see, check next slide. I think we have discussed this, I think. So when will may will be treated as shall? Duty coupled with discretion. It will be treated as shall. Positive benefit, again shall. Then if any remedy can be advanced and mischief suppressed, may shall be treated as shall. Or if giving any regular meaning, it defeats the purpose of that. That is the same thing. The mischief has to be suppressed, correct? May shall be treated as shall. Rule of adjustum generis. Bolo. Huh? General, what is the format? When will you use adjustum generis? There are some conditions, format. Specific word followed by general word. Specific means what? Particular meanings are given to it. And again, what is important now? Those specific words, if they form a class, species. Yaad hai? Huh. Then what? That general word will borrow the meaning or borrow the color from the particular specific words. Remember, what is the example of general words? And others, all these things, and others, etc. Any other person, any other business, other property, these are the examples, general words. Correct, no? Camel, elephant, rabbit, mammal is non-vegetarian, yes? Sorry, these are vegetarians, herbivores. So anything else will not fall in that meaning in the word of that, etc. Correct?